I agree it's Valentine's Day and you need to quickly wind up. And to help you quickly surf through the top news from the South here's Southern Circuit, I'm Pratibha Raman and we begin with the headlines. From 125 cases of child marriage reported in Kerala's Malappuram district in 2016, it has now risen to over 180 cases according to the child prevention officers. Lashing out at CM Siddaramaiah and the Congress government, former CM and JDS President H.D. Kumaraswamy said that 39 crore rupees has been spent on asphalting 1 kilometer road stretch. He went on to ask if the government is coating the road with gold or silver, stating that the tender had been given to a fraud company. An RTC bus was shifted to the police station when the bus allegedly did not give way to the convoy of Deputy CM of Andhra Pradesh, Nimmakayala Chinnarajappa. The incident reportedly took place at Mammidavaram, East Godavari district. In a blatant display of moral policing, members of a Hindu outfit tried to hand over thalis and garlands to 10 young men waiting for their beloveds at the Science Centre near Tirunelveli District Collectorate and asked them to marry the girls whom they love. Six members of the Hindu Makkal Katchi, including a woman, were involved in the incident. Police arrested three Hindu Makkal Katchi members in connection with the incident. When PM Modi was in Bengaluru for a rally, he had alleged that Siddaramaiah's Congress government in Karnataka was a 10% commission government. Now, JDS State President H.D. Kumaraswamy has agreed with Modi and has gone one step ahead to state that Siddaramaiah bags more money in the form of commission. And this has evoked a fitting response from the CM. Take a look at our Newsable pick of the day to witness the statements of the warring leaders prior to Karnataka election 2018.
ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಅವರು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಬಹಳ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ
ಎಲ್ಲಾರು ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದಾಖಲಾತಿ ಇರ್ತವೇನ್ರಿ ಇವಕ್ಕೆ
ಅದು ಬಹುಶಃ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ತಗೋತಾ ಇದೆ ಆ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ
ಲೆಟ್ ಹಿಮ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್
ಈ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಅವರು ಬಂದು ಏರಿಕೆ ಮಾಡೋರಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸರಿಯಾದ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಅವರು ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರು
ನಮ್ಮ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಮಿಷನ್ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಇಲ್ಲ
ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ
ಯಾರೋ ಲಂಚ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೋಣ ಇವು ಅಸುಮಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಫೂಲಿಶ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ
ಈ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಅವರು ಬಂದು ಏರಿಕೆ ಮಾಡೋರಲ್ಲ
ಅದೇನಿದ್ರು ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿ 100% ಕಮಿಷನ್ ಇತ್ತು
ಅದು ಸರಿಯಾದ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಅವರು ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ
Bajrang Dal members reportedly barged into a couple of restaurants and malls in Hyderabad to protest against Valentine's Day. Watch this viral video. The citizens of Kerala and Tamil Nadu have been enraged after the hike in bus fares recently. However, have you looked at the reason behind this move by the two state governments? We give you an overview to understand as to why this move is indeed good, justified and necessary.
After Tamil Nadu, now the Kerala government has also announced a hike in both state-owned and private bus fares, which will come into effect from March 1st. Along with a minimum fare, charges per kilometer for all category of services have also been raised. Both states have seen massive protests against the move from both the opposition parties and the general public, claiming the government was putting more burden on the people who were already suffering due to the steep rise in price of essential commodities. However, the fact is that the hike was necessary to sustain the transport sector in the states, especially with diesel prices on the rise for several months now. Though the state government should try to reduce the burden on its people, it is also responsible for ensuring the public transport survives all obstacles. Such services cannot run on losses for years, like the Kerala's KSRTC, which cannot even pay pension to its former employees, leading to several suicides. It is also not advisable for the government to cover the transport industry's losses with other sources of income. Such a solution is not sustainable for the long term. In Kerala, bus fares were last revised in 2014 and the price revision was made on the basis of the recommendations of a panel which went into the problems faced by the state's transport industry. And that shows it's a research and recommended move.
That's the end of our show. Without further ado, enjoy your Valentine's evening and see you tomorrow.